Welcome, Environmental Studies, 5th Standard, Lesson 7, Water. Water is very essential for the life of the plants and animals. Crops cannot be grown without water. Water is basic need for all. There are many uses of the water, so water is very important resource. It is called the life liquid. 71% of the earth's surface is covered by water. After studying this lesson, you know about the sources of water, understand the physical characteristics of the water, appreciate the biological importance of the water, know the importance of conservation methods of the water, verify the traditional and modern ways of water conservation. Recall the distribution of the water on the earth that you have learnt in the previous class. Answer the questions. Where can you find more water on the earth? Answer, oceans. Second question, what is consumable quantity of fresh water? Answer, only 2.5 to 2.75% is fresh water. Third one, what are the sources of fresh water? Answer, groundwater, surface water, streams, rivers, lakes, reservoirs. Fourth one, write here the sources of water that you know. Answer, oceans, rivers, wells, ponds. Rain is the main source of water. Let's know about the other sources. Oceans. Oceans are the biggest source of water on the earth. Look at this globe. Blue color indicates the portion of the earth covered by the water. Rivers. Rain is the source of river water also. Melted snow from the mountains reaches the river during the summer. So rivers overflow. All the rivers flow in their definite route and finally reach the ocean. Name some important rivers of Karnataka. Kaveri, Tungabhadra, Sharavati, Malaprabha, Kali River, Netravati, Bhadra, Tunga River. Springs. The water that is stored under the earth's crust and comes out due to the pressure through an opening is called spring. Rain water which enters the earth through its loose portions will be collected as underground water and this comes out in the form of the spring. Wells. Underground water obtained by digging the earth's crust to certain depth is called the well water. How many types of the wells are there? Which are they? Right here. Wells, bore wells, hand pumps. Know this. Due to the excessive utilization of the underground water, it is getting exhausted. It can be regained by the absorption of the rainwater into the earth. Soak. Pits must be constructed for this purpose. We have to minimize the utilization of the underground water and we have to follow some restoration methods like rainwater harvesting and recycling of the water. Ponds. An artificially man-made low-level portion of land to store water is called the pond. Its capacity of the water storage is less. It is constructed in a such a way that rainwater which drains from the high level will be stored here. Rainwater reaches ponds by running through the rivulets, small streams also. Reservoirs. Dams are constructed across the rivers to store water throughout the year and to supply water to places where there is a scarcity and also for the multi-purpose projects. These are capable of storing water in large scale and they are called the reservoirs. Write the names of the water reservoirs in Karnataka. Answer, Almatti, Basava, Sagara. Collect a picture of the water reservoir and paste here. With the help of these pictures, note down the differences of the pond and reservoir in these boxes. Write their uses also, get the help of the teacher. Okay, which is pond? This is a pond. I'll write P here, P on it, okay? Because all the water from the hill is going to be collected in this place and it is not going anywhere. It is a shallow, deep, a hole is there. In that hole, the water is being collected. It is called lake. This is also a pond. It is. Water is being collected in a particular place. It is not flowing out. This is a reservoir. This is a reservoir. This is also a reservoir. This is a reservoir. Backwater is there. This is a reservoir. Water is flowing from the reservoir to the fields for agriculture. Differences of the pond and reservoir. An artificially man-made low-level portion of the land is called pond. Its capacity of water is less. The dams are constructed across the rivers. These are storage capable of storing water in large scale. Uses of the pond and reservoir. Ponds, lawns and soil-based plants require watering, and it's good to have somewhere for the rainwater to go instead of being wasted. Reservoirs used to generate electricity, irrigation, human consumption and industrial use agriculture. Think our elders constructed tanks, ponds and open wells to conserve water. Nowadays, reservoirs are constructed to conserve water. Which one is too eco-friendly among these? Why? Collect the information about the tank, pond, open well or reservoir which are near to your locality. Visit your locality, that means your local place, where are the ponds are available, and collect the name of that place. It is an activity. In which kind of the place it is constructed, how is the water collected, what are its uses, in which season of the year will it be full, in which season will it be empty or less, why? You collect all the information. It's an activity. From which source do you collect water in your house and at the school? Right here. At home, where do you collect the water? Okay, in the water tank. Water tank at the ground and above, also one tank is there. In the tap water will come, and from where you'll get the water, right? And at the school, same water tank will be there. Water will be coming from the rivers, pipeline, through the pipeline water is coming. You'll get in the tap the water. These are the sources of the water at the school. These are the uses of the water at home. What are the uses of the water for drinking? Drinking. Here also drinking. For school also drinking water is required, right? At home cooking. At school cleaning. Cleaning department uses water. Then what? Washing dishes. At home, washing clothes at home. And here, for what purpose you use water other than this? Hand wash at the school. Hand wash. Okay, then for toiletry. Sorry, toilet. You use a water at home also for toilet. You need water. Now this, in the list of the uses that you wrote, have you considered the use of the transportation? The people also travel on the water. Yacht boats are used for the short distances and also catch fishes. Ships are used to travel longer distances. Do this, collect the flowing rainwater in the glass bottle. Collect the raindrop directly in the bottle. Look at their color. Write the difference that you find. Directly in the bottle or the glass water, then you look at the color, it will be colorless water. Colorless water will collect rainwater. Take 2 glasses of the water, add 2 spoonful of sugar to 1 glass and spoon of salt to another. Stir them and taste both. Write down what we have understood. Sweet taste will come after adding sugar to it. Okay. Salty taste will come after adding salt to the glass of water. Pure water is colorless, odorless and tasteless. Salts and minerals dissolved in the water are responsible for its taste. Do these activities with the help of the teachers and parents. Then mark true or false. Correct the wrong statements. Lift an empty tumbler and the tumbler of the same size filled with the water. Water has a weight. Statement. True. Pour a cup of water on the stairs. Water does not flow from higher level towards the lower level. False. When you pour a water on the stairs, it will flow downwards. Boil the water in a small vessel. Water evaporates when it boils. True. Put some specific quantity of water in the glass tumbler and the glass bottle, a glass vessel. Water does not take the shape of the container. False. It takes in which vessel you added the water. That shape it will take. You have learned some physical characteristics of the water. Water is liquid substance. You will learn more about it in lesson nature of the matter. Let us learn the biological importance of the water. Organisms have enormous quantity of water in their body. Plants and animals have 70% of the water in their body. Origin of every early life took place in the water. Water is essential for the biological activities of the plants and animals. Water is required for the growth of the plants. Green plants need water for the production of their food. Think, what happens if required quantity of water is not supplied to plants? Plants will die. Our elders treated this precious water as an integral part of their life. They reserved the prominent place for the water in their family rituals. Have you observed this at your home or in your neighborhood? Which are the practices of worshipping water that you have seen in your home or in the neighborhood? At home, we celebrate during the Deepavali, 1 day, 3 days Deepavali will be celebrated. 1 day is called the filling of the water festival. They fill the water in a pot and do puja to it and celebrate it. When we are, they celebrated right here. And even some season, rivers will be worshipped. Okay. How do water sources get polluted? Answer. Water is physically polluted by mud, garbage, paper, food residuals, etc. Water mixed with the industrial chemicals, chemical fertilizers, insecticides have dangerous components which turns the water poisonous. Water pollution. Water is physically polluted by the mud, garbage, paper, food residuals, etc. Water mixed with the industrial chemicals, chemical fertilizers and insecticides which have dangerous components turns the water poisonous. Drinking this water may cause diseases like the cholera, diarrhea, dysentery, etc. Sometimes it may even lead to death. Contaminated water extinguishes the aquatic life also. Here they are dumping the garbage into the pond. Here they are dumping the industrial pollution to the water resource. Here pond, they are washing the buffaloes in the river, washing their clothes. It will pollute the water. It will be unfit for drinking. Then if they wash your clothes in there, do you drink the clothes washed bucket water for drinking? No, you will not use that. No, that's why it is also a source of water. We should preserve it, should not pollute that, should not wash the clothes in the rivers. Know this. You know about the disease cholera caused by the contaminated water. Mosquitoes breed on stagnant water. Mosquitoes spread malaria disease. The parasites Plasmodium is present in the body of the female mosquito called the anopheles. This parasite enters the human blood when the mosquito bites and leads to the symptoms of the fever, shivering, vomiting and headache. This is called the malaria. If proper treatment is not given, it may cause death. We should not drink contaminated water. Health can be maintained properly by drinking potable water. Prepare and exhibit a chart in your class by discussing with your friends about what you will do to get pure and potable water. Please subscribe my channel, hit the bell icon and save the playlist. Thank you very much. Bye bye.